There's a very, very popular punching bag in gyms that I go to. It's called the Aqua Punching Bag. Check it out. It's full of water. I've seen one at the Mayweather gym. I've seen one in many, many different gyms. Mm-hmm. Ryan, why do you like this bag and what's good about it?
I like the weight on it.
Uh-huh. The angles need to work?
Oh, definitely. You know, angles, you can come in at any particular angle. Boom, 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 boom. The fact that it's good absorbent in terms of like punching into it. You don't have to worry too much about hurting your hands. The water in it allows it to maintain more balance, but if you start thinking it's gonna do a bounce, boom, boom, bam, 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 ooh. Use it as a tool, or if you want, use it as like a resistance type tool, you know, just stay in position. Stay here. It comes back, but it gets a little heavier and heavier and heavier as you keep trying to keep it off. It's a great tool for a lot of things, definitely. It's just for working out in general. This is a great tool, definitely. And what's cool is if you're trying to come to the open rack, you can use it right here. Got the same up here, you can come in like that.
Versus, let's go to a regular heavy bag.
Regular heavy bag, something like this, well...
No angles like that, obviously.
Yeah.
You can't come from the bottom. You can't come with the overhand right at the same angle.
No, exactly. You do have to...
And this weighs about 150 pounds, so when you punch it, you don't go like with the water.
Exactly. So it's more in the sense...
It doesn't absorb it the same.
It's more of a sturdier base to it, but unless you're George Foreman, you can just put dents in that thing like fucking... Something like that.
Oh, like that, yeah. You're just like George Foreman. Watch out for Ryan Mason.
I'm not even close. Although I do love you, George, but you're the man, definitely. Yeah, not with...
So, if you had to work this bag, give us like a 30-second or 1-minute workout. How would you do it?
Okay, all right. Now start to move around a little bit. So it's giving you some area to try to move. That's all I'm going to say in position. Just try to maintain some balance, but have some resistance as well, too. Okay, so I want to practice my uppercuts. Practice my uppercuts. Ankles, uppercuts, hooks. Over hand right. Over like that.
There you have it, Ryan Mason putting in the work on a Sunday morning.
I'm trying to.
Rocky and his t-shirt.
Watch out for Creed.
I don't know. Did you see that new commercial with Larry Merchant and Stallone?
Put school in Larry because Sly knows his boxing. Yes, yeah, I did see that commercial.
But they should have taken Mayweather Sr. or Roger against Larry Merchant. Because both of them have pretty much the same opinion about Mayweather Pacquiao. I think Stallone and Larry Merchant going for Manny. I respect that. That's their opinion. But they should have brought someone that was, you know what I mean? Like, that could...
I understand what you're saying, Ellie, but if you're bringing in someone like Roger Mayweather or Floyd Sr. talking with...
Okay, forget that. Okay, that's family. Okay.
Yeah, it's family is going
to
be more biased.
How about you bring in... What?
It's family is going to be more biased in that sense.
Larry Merchant's not biased?
Don't even get me started.
Okay, there you go. So what I'm saying, if they're going to do that, bring in two people in the polar opposites. Don't bring two people with the same opinion to try to argue for the other side.
Well, here's the thing I understand about Sly. Sly's a big Pacquiao fan.
Exactly, that's what I said. I know.
He's known Manny for a very long time. Yeah. I was at the fight at the Grand Olympic Auditorium when Fernando Vargas came back, fought Fitz Vanderpool on the undercard. It was Manny Pacquiao. Manny was
Rapper Garcia, too, was there.
Of course, he was working with Fernando at the time. And I remember... After the fight was over, and let's remember, this is before Manny, the big superstar.
Yeah,
he is.
Way before De La Hoya.
Way before De La Hoya days, dude.
Yeah.
So, I it was a packed. Stars everywhere: Stallone, Danny Trejo, Tito Ortiz. I mean, you name it, they were there, pretty much. And then I see Sly, gives like a nod to Manny.
Angelina Jolie.
No.
Okay. Okay. No. Keep going. I'm sorry.
But nonetheless, I remember after the fight was over, Sly's outside the ring. Manny sees him. He's like, hey, like that. And Sly's like, you know, gives him like
good
a
job,
fist bump.
Yeah.
And then like Manny comes out of the ring to give him a fist bump. And Sly's like, you know, like that. Yeah. You know? And this was way a long time ago. So Sly has always been a Manny fan. He has.
But a lot of people are Manny fans. How can you not be? You know,
But in the commercial, he was keeping it real about Mayweather's ability. Yo, it looked like he was favoring Mayweather on that shit, dog. And that's being a realist as well, too. He's a fan of Manny.
They should have Bernard Hopkins. They should have Merchant and Bernard Hopkins.
But
in my opinion, if you have someone pro Mayweather and someone pro Pacquiao, make it even. Don't take two. You know, you're not getting what I'm
saying. Are you saying in the sense that Sly, because he's not a commentator, not a promoter, not in the.
I'm saying he's a Pacquiao fan and he's going for Pacquiao no matter what. So how are you gonna have a Pacquiao fan argue Floyd's angle point of view? That's what I'm saying.
He's just being a realist, Ellie. See, this is like one of the videos that you did with Wonderful Boys a long time ago, or maybe recently. I'm sorry. Talking about how you could be a fan of somebody, but you want to see some things happen to them. Maybe just to put them in position or to humble them or something like that. Who knows? But, you know, like myself. Okay.
And who would want to have breakfast with Larry Merchant anyways?
You know, I'm not... I can't answer that. I can't answer that, man. When it comes to Larry Merchant, man, I mean... Bottom line is, yeah, he's always been a Manny fan, and he's always favored Manny, you know, but...
And Gene told me he has a hairpiece.
I wouldn't be surprised. But again, the topic on Sly, you see, you can definitely be a boxing fan of a fighter, but you got to have a realist point of view at this sometimes. This is where you can't allow your heart and your emotion to overcloud your mind in terms of being a fan. I'll use myself as an example, okay? Well, when Fernando Vargas lost to Trinidad, oh, it broke my heart. I was one of the biggest Fernando fans out there, definitely. He's one of the reasons why I wanted to get into boxing. And when he lost, yeah, my heart was broken. And for a little while, I was like, oh, but Fernando boxed. He could have done this. Oh, but if he did this, he could have done this. Could have, would have, should have. But it didn't happen. We got to get over it. We got to move on. It is what it is. But you stay being a fan of the fighter, but you're brought back down to reality that your favorite fighter is no longer invincible. And that's one of those things that it's heartbreaking, but it's a wake-up call too. And then the last time that happened, oh shit.
What's wrong?
No. My heart's just, I'm still
you were still working hard work, dedication.
I'm trying to speak at the same time. But the last time that happened was when Jeff Lacy fought Calzaghe. I was on the Lacy train hardcore. I was like, yo, Lacy's the future. Lacy's like the next Tyson. Yo, Lacy's gonna do this. He's knocking everybody out. If you were watching Jeff Lacy back then, you know exactly what I'm talking about, okay? I had only seen Joe fought one time. I wasn't really that impressed by it. So I was convinced that Lacy was gonna go over to England and knock him out. Oh, ho, 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 ho.
You were wrong.
Oh, boy.
That's boxing. That's boxing.